Welcome you all. Next concept we have generation of high voltage and high currents. In the field of electrical engineer and the applied physics, high voltages are used in several applications like electron microscope and X-ray units, which is required high DC voltage of the order 100 kV or even more. Like we have electrostatic precipitators, particle accelerator and nuclear physics, etc., which requires very high voltage of the DC, several kilowatts and even in terms of megawatts as well. High AC voltage of 1 million watts or even more, which is required for testing of power apparatus, for EHV, that is nothing but extra high voltage transmission line purpose, and high impulse voltages, which are required for testing of a simulate over voltage that occurs in power system due to lightning and switching surges. So these are the purpose for measure generation of the very high voltages in the laboratory for the testing, which is essential, which is required what we explain for the concepts. The classifications of different high voltages, like high DC voltages, high AC voltages of power frequency, then we have high AC voltages of high frequency, then high transient, or generally we'll call it as impulse voltages of very short duration, such as lightning over voltages, then we have testing transient over voltages of long duration, such as switching surges. So you can see to that, it is AC, we have two different things subjected to that, a power frequency and the high frequency. Then we have impulse voltages for the short duration and long duration. So short duration is subjected to the lightning and long duration is subjected to the switching surges. So normally in high voltage testing, the current under condition of the failure is limited to very small value. But in certain cases, like testing of surge diverters or short circuit testing of the switching gears, high current testing with the several hundred of the amperes, it is also very important. Like testing of surge diverters, which is required high current of the order of several kiloamperes. Therefore, the test facility requires high voltage and the high current. High impulse current generation is also required along with high voltage for the testing purpose. Let's discuss step by step. First one, generation of high DC voltages. Generation of high DC voltages, which is required in research work, the areas of pure and applied physics. Sometimes high DC voltages are needed in the insulation testing, the cables and the capacitors. Impulse generation charging units are also required high DC voltages of around 100 to 200 kV. Normally, generation of DC voltages of up to 100 kV. Electron wall type rectifiers are used and the output current is of 100 milliamperes. The rectifier walls require special type of construction for the cathode and the filaments, since a high electrostatic field of several kilovolt per centimeter exists between the anode and the cathode in non-conduction period. Then we are going to have different type of the method for the generation of high DC voltages. First one is half and full wave rectifier. Then we have voltage doubler circuit. Then We are going to discuss voltage multiplier circuit. Then we are going to discuss electrostatic machines. That is nothing but we will call it as Van der Graaff generators. Coming to that next concept, half wave and full wave rectifier devices. The rectifier may be of electron tube or solid state devices. Nowadays, a single electron tube are available for the peak inverse up to 250 kV. And the semiconductor or solid state devices, solid state diodes, up to a 20 kV. For higher voltages, several units are to be used in the series. When the number of the units are used in the series, transient voltage distribution along each unit becomes non-uniform, and the special care has to be taken to make the distribution uniform. Then coming to the half wave rectifier device, in this the capacitor is charged to V maximum value. AC voltage of the secondary of the high voltage transformer in the conducting half cycle. This is conducting in half cycle. In other half cycle, capacitor is discharged into the load. The value of the capacitor, which is chosen such that this multiplication capacitor and RL value is at least 10 times of the period of AC input voltage. The rectifier valve must have a peak inverse of 2V maximum. To limit the charging current, an additional resistance which is added in series with the secondary of the transformer. So this is how actually the half wave rectifier devices will work, and also we know that. Then coming to that, the full wave rectifier device. In the positive half cycle, the rectifier A conducts and charges the capacitor C. While in the negative half cycle, rectifier B conducts and charges the capacitor. The source transformer, which is requires a center tap secondary with a maximum value of 2V. For the application of high voltage of 50 kV and above, rectifier valves are used of special construction. Apart from filament, the cathode and the anode, they contain a protective shield or a grid around the filament and the cathode. In modern high voltage laboratories and the testing installations, semiconductors rectifier stacks are commonly used for production of DC voltages. Semiconductor diodes are not true valves since they have finite but very small conduction in the backward direction. The commonly preferred diodes for high voltage rectifier are silicon diodes with a peak inverse of 1 to 2 kV. Both full wave and half wave rectifiers produces DC voltages less than the AC maximum voltage, and also there is a ripple or voltage fluctuation will be present, and this has to be kept within a reasonable limit by using the filters. Then ripple voltage with the half wave and full wave rectifiers. When there is a load, the capacitor get charged from the supply and discharge into the load resistance RL. Whenever the supply voltage waveforms varies from the peak value to the zero value, so which is shown in these figures, when loaded, fluctuation in the output DC voltage, that is delta V, appears, and this is called as ripple. The ripple voltage delta V, which is large in the case of half wave rectifier compared to that a full wave rectifier. This is for the input voltage, and this is for half wave, this is for the full wave. And this is nothing but V maximum mean value and the ripple voltage with respect to delta V by using that condenser of the capacitors. So delta V is large for half wave and which is less for the full wave rectifier. Delta V, which is depending upon the so many parameters like input frequency and the time constant, that is the capacitor and the RM value and the reactance of the transformer XL. For half wave rectifier, the ripple frequency which is equal to that the supply frequency, and for the full wave rectifier it is twice that the value. So this has to be minimum, and there must be a proper choice of the filter capacitor and the transformer reactance for the given load RL value. If not, there is an increase in the value of delta V, resulting in there is an output there which is considered with a ripple which have in the maximum value. Both the full wave and half wave rectifiers produces a DC voltage which is less than the AC maximum voltages. And higher DC voltages are required, we will go for by using a simple voltage doubler circuit or cascaded voltage doubler circuit. We'll see to that a simple voltage doubler circuit. The capacitor C1, which is charged to the charge through the rectifier R1 with the V maximum value with the polarity which is shown in the figure and during the negative half cycle. As the voltage of the transformer rises to the positive, that is nothing but V maximum during the next half cycle, the potential of the other terminal of the C1 rises to a 2V maximum. Thus, the capacitor C2 in terms charged to a 2V maximum. Normally, the DC output voltage on the load will be which is less than the 2V maximum. It is depending upon the value of the capacitor C2 and the RL and the forward charging time constants. Cascaded voltage doubler circuit which are used for the larger output voltages without changing the input of the transformer voltage level. A typical which is shown, the figure which is shown here, it is same as the simple voltage double circuit which you can see to that R1, R2, C1, C2 and the transformer in place that, okay, which is same as this whole circuit, which is same as the voltage doubler circuit. The rectifier R1 and the R2 with the transformer T1 and the capacitor C1, C2 is duplicated and connected in series or cascade to obtain a further voltage or doubling to a 4V maximum. T, this is nothing but it is an isolating transformer for the insulation of 2V maximum. Since the transformer T2 is at potential of 2V maximum, which is above the 2V maximum, the voltage distribution along the rectifier, that is R1, R2, R3 and R4, which is made uniform by having the capacitor C1, C2, C3 and the C4 of the equal values. The arrangement may be extended for a 6 volts, 8 volts, okay, and so on, repeating the further steps with proper using of the isolating transformer. This is of the very important thing. Transformer had to be suitably designed and should be insulated. All the cathodes will not be at the same potential from the ground. The arrangement become cumbersome if more than 4 volt is needed with the cascade steps. So this is the output which you can see that waveform of AC voltage and the DC output voltage on no load of the voltage doubler circuit. First one is nothing but the input voltage 1. Second one is for with the capacitor filter. Okay. Third one, DC output voltage waveform with the capacitor filters.